everybody, what's going on? Welcome on down back to the Axe Slinger. Today on Gear Reviews, we go ahead and check this out. This is a Fender Limited Edition HH Flame Top. This thing fucking rules. Hope you guys enjoyed that quick little rundown of Alice in Chains, them bones. This guitar nails that 90s grunge tone. It's fucking awesome. Let's get into what this thing is all about. Alright, so, first of all, we got a hardtail. That is just fucking awesome on a Telecaster. The fact that you've got a hardtail, I'm a huge fan of a hardtail. You've got a tone and volume knob, and we got push-pull. So we can go split each of these in single coil if you want to. There's a three-way toggle switch. It's nice. It's out of the way. You're not going to feel it when you're playing. And we've got 22 nice medium jumbo frets on this thing. Beautiful. Look at that. Look at the flame top on that thing. It is gorgeous. This is called Amber Burst. Beautiful color. This thing came loaded stock with two Seymour Duncan humbuckers. We have a Pearly Gates in the bridge and a JB59 in the neck. So you're going to get awesome crunchy tones in the bridge, nice liquidy smooth buttery leads in the neck. We have got a Fender stock tuners there, and look at the headstock. Beautiful wood finish lacquered on that. You got a lacquered neck finish too on the back, and you've got a beautiful graphite no nut right there. It's so nice. And look at the frets. Look at that abalone inlays on this thing. And we've got gorgeous neck binding. Look at the neck binding on that thing all the way around. And the back of this thing is gorgeous. Look at that. I love that it's a hardtail string through design. This thing is going to resonate. And look at that. It is not a bolt-on. It is a set neck. Set neck. Absolutely gorgeous. And look how thin it is. It's got the weight relief, so you're not going to feel like it's pulling you down like a traditional Telecaster. It's contoured, so nice belly cut out there so that it doesn't hit into your ribs while you're playing. I am absolutely floored by this guitar. There's my sticker. I'm calling it Santa Cruz. Reminds me of California, this thing. And I've been very fortunate to be blessed with getting quite a bit of guitars lately. And yeah, I absolutely love this thing. It was posted on Kijiji, and I had no choice but to jump on it. I got it for a very, very good deal. And go ahead, leave me a comment down in the comment section. Let me know, what do you think of this thing? Is this thing kind of too out of the ordinary for a Fender? Is it something that people like? Do you like this? I think it's killer. Now, the background story on this guitar is it's actually built in the carbon factories. Okay, so that's a good thing. You're getting excellent craftsmanship. Excellent. Not a single stone was, you know, looked over on this. Now, this guitar is made in Indonesia. So that might be, you know, a bit of a turnoff for people. It's not American or Mexican, but it absolutely fucking rips. It's got a nice rosewood neck on it. And I'm just absolutely floored. I can't, say, the humbuckers alone are worth hundreds of dollars. You're getting a bargain. I believe this thing retails brand new for right around that $1,000 mark. It's about $750-$800 US, so about $1,100 Canadian. I mean, good luck finding another guitar that's going to offer you the same bang for the buck that this thing has given you. I always give honest reviews. I'm not endorsed, sponsored, or forced to tell you guys any bullshit. My rating on this is a 5 out of 5. Tell you why. Stays in tune. Check. Does it have excellent tonality? Check. Does it have versatility? Yes, it does, with the push-pull, and it's got variants of pickups, so there's another check. The look of it. Look at that. That looks like a premium guitar. It's almost like a Les Paul meets PRS in a Fender. I mean, what more can you ask for? You know, and I like, again, as I said, this thing, if you can find them, they're hard to find. Apparently, there is a reissue coming of it, but they come in two other finishes. There is a red black cherry finish, and then there's a spalted maple. Personally, I think this is the best out of all the finishes. If you can find this one, you won't regret it. Trust me. Anyway, thank you so much for stopping by to my channel. I'm so grateful to all you subscribers and my followers. I've cracked 200. Thank you so much. It means the world to me. If you're new, hit the subscribe button and stay tuned. New and exciting things always coming from yours truly, the Axe Slinger. Thank you so much. Stay safe. Remember to keep it heavy. All right. Cheers.